Hello everyone, myself Engineer Amol Gadde, lecturer from the Department of Civil Engineering, Praveen Patil College of Diploma Engineering and Technology, Bhayandar. So guys, today I am going to give you a presentation on fifth chapter of your syllabus of Geotechnical Engineering, which named as Compaction and Stabilization of Soil. So this particular chapter is weighted for 16 marks into your Geotech syllabus. So this particular chapter is basically divided into three major parts. Very first one is concept of compaction, consolidation. Second one is concept of soil stabilization, and very third one is a necessity of site investigation. So let us, without wasting any typical time, let us start with compaction of soil, or we can call it as introduction part. So what is compaction of soil? It is defined as the process of packing soil particles closely together by mechanical means, thus increasing the dry density of soil. By this process of reduction in voids, soil mass takes place rapidly by the blow of hammer, or due to vibration, or by passing a roller. For the improvement of soil properties, example like density, water content, gradation, compaction is necessary in the construction of embankment, roads upgrade, or a dam, etc. Compaction helps to reduce the settlement, permeability, seepage, etc. Actually, compaction expelled air from the void space in the soil mass and increased the density. Compaction generally increases the shear strength, bearing capacity, and makes it more stable against the structural failure. During the design of structure, the foundation or base of structure is the main part. This base of structure raised on subgrade or subbase of soil strata. Therefore, the property of soil plays an important role, and it is compulsory to know the soil property of subsoil for the designer. To improve the property of soil, certain mechanical methods can apply. So the compaction is one of the such method, which is done for improving the density of soil for having high bearing capacity and less permeability during the lifespan of the structure. So high density or increased density due to compaction ensures to resist the future settlement and water tightness. So here is the purpose behind compaction. Due to compaction, soil particles are rearranged and packed closely. Therefore, shear strength increases. Due to compaction, air voids reduces, so porosity decreases, which helps for low permeability and water tightness. Chances of further settlement reduces with the help of compaction, because soil particles are closely packed together and volume decreases after compaction. Compaction increases the dry density, which is cause for increase in bearing capacity of soil. Compaction helps to improve the engineering properties of soil, that is bearing capacity, shearing strength, permeability of soil, which helps the structure to have stable and long lifespan. Here are some field situations where compaction is more required. For the construction of embankment, for the construction of roads upgrade, for the construction of earthen dams, for the foundation soil in building, for reducing the settlement of foundation, for improving bearing capacity of soil. Here is the concept behind consolidation. The process of gradual removal of water from pores of saturated soil by pressure which acts for long period is called as consolidation. Consolidation is a slower process of decreasing the volume of soil mass, whereas compaction is a quicker process of reducing the volume of soil mass by dynamic loading. When a load is applied or increased on a soil which is not fully saturated, comparatively sudden reduction in the volume of soil occurs, which is mainly due to expulsion and compression of air in the voids. This phenomenon is termed as initial consolidation. If the equilibrium is not attained after initial consolidation, further reduction in volume continues, which is mainly due to squeezing out of water from the voids. This reduction in volume of soil, which is mainly due to squeezing out of the water from the voids, is termed as primary consolidation. Thus, for the partially saturated soil, initial consolidation precedes primary consolidation. If the soil is saturated, the major part of the volume change is due to primary consolidation. Even after the reduction of the excess hydrostatic pressure to zero, or after removal of all pore water, some compression of soil takes place at very slow rate. This is known as secondary consolidation. Here is a standard Proctor test. Compaction of any soil is measured quantitatively in terms of dry density. There are a number of laboratory tests that have been developed for compacting the soil. The main aim of this test is to arrive at some standard which will be basis of compaction comparison for field compaction. Among all the laboratory compaction tests, the device designed by R.R. Proctor has become very popular and is known as standard Proctor compaction test. So, main object behind this test is to determine the optimum moisture content and maximum dry density of soil by Proctor test and to plot the curve of zero air voids. Here, Indian standard code 2720, in which part 7 and part 8, which is published in 1965, is mainly used for this particular test. So, talking about theory, compaction is the process of densification of soil by reducing air voids. The degree of compaction of soil is measured in terms of the dry density. The degree of compaction mainly depends upon its moisture content, compaction energy, and type of soil. For a given compaction energy, soil attains the maximum dry density at a particular water content, which is known as optimum moisture content. Compaction of soil increases their density, shear strength, bearing capacity, but reduces their void ratio, porosity, permeability, and settlement. Laboratory compaction test results are used to write the compaction specification for field compaction of soil. The apparatus which is used for this process is a cylindrical mould with volume 1000 cc, that is 1000 cubic centimeter, which is having 10 cm diameter and 12.73 cm height, which is fitted with detachable base plate and collar approximate 6 cm height. A metal rammer is also used, then balances, electric oven, moisture content can, etc., and sieves of 50 mm, 20 mm and 4.75 mm are also used. So, starting with preparation of specimen, take 16 kg of airtight sample passing through 20 mm ISCU. Apply water to bring water content about 10% less than the estimated optimum moisture content or optimum water content. Keep the soil in an airtight tin for about 20 hours to ensure through mixing of the water with the soil. Divide the sample in 6 equal parts. Moving further to procedure, clean the empty mould, dry and weight it to nearest gram. Apply grease to inside of the mould, top of the base plate and inside of collar. Fit the base plate and collar to the mould and place the assembly on the floor. Take one part of soil and fill the mould with 3 equal layers and give 25 blues to each layer from the rammer having mass 2.6. kg, dropping from a height of 310 mm. Scratch with a spatula every compacted layer before putting the soil for succeeding layers. Remove the collar and trim the compacted soil level with the top of the mould by means of straight edge. Weigh the mould with the soil again to nearest 1 gram. Extract the soil from mould by extruder. Cut the soil sample in the middle and take representative soil specimen in an airtight container from the middle of cut surface. Determine the moisture content of their representative sample. Repeat above step, taking fresh sample using 2-3% more water than the preceding specimen. Calculate the bulk density of the compacted soil for each test. Calculate corresponding dry density and water content for each test. Draw a curve showing the relationship between moisture content and dry density. Find out dry density corresponding to the maximum point of the curve and corresponding moisture content. This dry density is known as maximum dry density MDD and the moisture content as optimum moisture content OMC. Here we also need to follow some precautions. Clean the mould, base plate and collar at the end of each reading and apply grease to inside the mould, top of the base plate and inside the collar before going for next test. See that blows of rammer are uniformly distributed on a soil specimen. The rammer should not strike the collar while giving blows. For every blow, ensure that the height of fall of rammer is 310 mm for light compaction. The last layer after compaction should not project more than 5 mm above top of the mold. So this is a compaction curve. This particular curve is plotted with respect to moisture content in percentage and dry density. A curve is plotted between water content as abisca and the corresponding to dry density as ordinate as shown in figure. It is observed that the dry density initially increases with an increase in water content till the maximum density is attained. With further increase in water content, the dry density decreases. At a water content lower than the optimum, the soil is rather stiff and has a lot of void spaces and therefore the dry density is low. As the water content increases, the soil particles get lubricated and slip over each other and move into densely packed position and the dry density increases. Starting with OMC, that is optimum moisture content. The water content corresponding to maximum dry density is known as optimum moisture content. From figure, the moisture content at peak of the curve is termed as optimum and dry and density is termed as maximum. Hence the limiting value of water content at which the dry density is maximum called as OMC, that is optimum moisture content. Talking about importance of OMC, when the water is added to the sample, soil grains get surrounded by a film of water. Layer of water becomes thicker and thicker by adding water. This film helps in sliding of particles when compacted effort is applied or helps in close packing during the addition of water doses. A stage will reach when there is maximum packing. This stage is called as optimum moisture content. So OMC, there is maximum lubrication benefit. At optimum moisture content, there is a maximum packing, which means maximum density. Due to maximum density, bearing capacity of soil will be more, or it can be bear more load. Due to optimum moisture content, there is maximum density and less voids. Hence, it helps in reducing the porosity or permeability, etc. At OMC, due to compression, the soil particles pass maximum, which helps to reduce the further compressibility or settlement. So, at OMC, degree of compaction of soil is maximum. Moving further to maximum dry density. So, it is clear that there is a maximum dry density of particular moisture content. At initial stage, dry density increases with increase in moisture content. A stage comes when the peak of curve is reached at a particular moisture content. Further, there is increase in moisture content, but limb of the curve declines, which indicates that density decreases with increase in further moisture content. So, at the peak, there is a density known as maximum dry density, and related moisture content is known as OMC, which is optimum moisture content. So moving further to zero air void line, the line which shows the relation between water content, Dry density for the compacted soil having a constant percentage of air void is known as air void line. It can be estimated from the relationship of dry density, that is gamma d is equal to g gamma w upon 1 plus e into bracket 1 minus na, where e is wg upon s. So we put the value of e as wg upon s, where na is percent air void, w is water content of compacted soil, gamma d is dry density corresponding to w, and g is specific gravity. Moving further to modified Proctor test. The modified Proctor test was developed to represent heavier compaction than in the standard Proctor test. This test is used to stimulate the field condition where heavy rollers are used. In the modified Proctor test, the mould used to use is the same as in the standard Proctor test. However, the rammer used is much heavier and has a greater drop than that is the standard Proctor test. Its mass is 4.89 kg, and the free drop is 450 mm. The face diameter is 50 mm as in the standard Proctor test. The soil is compacted in 5 equal layers. Each layer is given 25 blues. The compactive effort in the modified Proctor test, measured in kilojoule per meter cube of soil, is about 4.56 times that in the standard Proctor test. Thus, a much heavier compaction is attained. If the percentage of soil retained on 4.75 mm ISC is more than 20%, the larger mould of 150 mm internal diameter, effective height of 127.3 mm and capacity 2250 ml is used. In case of 56 blues are required for each layer. The rest of procedure is similar to that of the standard Proctor test. The dry densities are obtained for different water content and the compaction curve is drawn. The following figure shows the compaction curve for modified Proctor test. The curve 1 is of standard Proctor test and curve 2 is of modified Proctor test. The curve is higher than the left of the obtained from standard Proctor test, that is curve number 1. The heavier compaction increases the maximum dry density but decreases the optimum water content. The percentage increase of the dry density is in between 3 to 8% for most soil. The percentage increases is more for clay soil than for sandy soil. Here you can also see zero air void line which have saturation level as 100%. Moving further to various factors which affects the compaction and hence dry density of soil are as follows. Very first one is water content. Water content is an important parameter in compaction. Compaction depends upon amount of water content. It is clear from laboratory experiment that as the water content is increased, the compacted density goes on increasing till maximum dry density is achieved. After further addition of water decreases the density. Second one is amount of compaction. The amount of compaction greatly affect the maximum dry density and optimum moisture content of the given soil. The effect of increasing the amount of compaction effort result increase in the maximum dry density and decrease in optimum moisture content. Third one is type of soil. A well-graded coarse grain soil can be compacted to higher degree compared to the uniform soil for some compacted effort. As the soil tends towards more and more fine grained nature, the optimum moisture content values goes on increasing and MDD value goes on decreasing for the same compaction effort. Next one is method of compaction. Method of compaction is also an important factor which affect compaction. dry density not only depend upon the amount of compaction, the type of soil and moisture content, but also on the method of compaction, manner of operation, time and contact area between the soil and the equipment. Last one is admixture. Various admixtures like lime, calcium chloride, aggregate in various productions are utilized to improve the compaction properties. The use and amount of this admixture depend upon the type of soil to be compacted. Certain chemical admixtures like lime can increase the dry density about 5 to 10% under the same compaction energy. Next are field method of compaction. Various methods are used for compaction of soil in the field. The choice of the method or best one studies on the job will depend upon the nature of soil, thickness of layer, maximum dry density and economic consideration. Nature of soil is most important consideration in the selection of the type of the compactor for a job. Field compaction is carried out by the various methods. So very first method is compaction by rolling, second one is compaction by rammer, third one is compaction by vibratory compactor, and fourth one is compaction by tamping. So starting with first, compaction by rolling. Rollers of different types are used for compaction of soil. The compaction by rollers depend upon the factors such as contact pressure, number of passes, layer thickness, speed of roller, etc. It also having certain types. Very first type is smooth wheel roller. A smooth wheel roller generally consists of three wheels, two large wheel in the rear and one small wheel in the front. A tandem type smooth wheel roller consists of only two drums, one in the rear and one in the front. The mass of a smooth wheel roller generally varies between 10 to 16 ton. These rollers are operated by internal combustion agencies. Talking about suitability, smooth wheel rollers are useful for finishing operation after compaction of fields and for compacting granular base course of highways. These rollers are best suitable for subgrade or base course compaction of cohesionless soils, well graded sand, gravel mixture. Second type of roller is pneumatic tire roller. These rollers generally consist of 9 to 11 wheels fixed on two axles with pneumatic tires, so space that a complete coverage is obtained with each pass of the roller. The rollers are available in the wide range of load sizes between 5 to 200 tons. The inflation pressure varies between 200 to 1000 kN per meter square. These rollers are available as the self-propelled unit as well as towed unit. These rollers compact the soil primarily by kneading action. Suitability of this type of roller is pneumatic tires rollers are effective for compacting cohesive as well as cohesionless soils. Light rollers which mass up to 20 tons are effective for compacting soil layers of small thickness up to 15 cm, whereas heavy rollers are useful for layers of thickness up to 30 cm. Third type is ship foot rollers. The ship foot roller consists of a hollow drum with a large number of small projections known as feet on its surface. These projections penetrate in the soil layers during rolling operation and cause compaction. The drums are mounted on the steel frame. The drum can be filled with water or ballast to increase the mass. The ship foot rollers are available both as self-propelled and towed unit with 2.5 to 13 tons weight. So, talking about suitability, suitable only for fine-grained cohesive soils. Example, silty clay and clay. Best suited for compaction of impervious zone of earthen dam. It is suitable for compacting lower layer of soil because it does not provide the proper finish to upper surface. Second type of field compaction is compaction by rammers. Rammers or tampers are mainly of two type, hand operated and mechanical rammer. A hand operated tamper consists of a block of iron or stone about 3 to 5 kg in mass attached to a wooden rod. The tamper is lifted for about 0.3 meter and dropped on the soil to be compacted. A mechanical rammer is operated by compressed air or gasoline power. It is much heavier, about 30 to 50 kg. Mechanical rammers have been used up to the mass 1000 kg in some special cases. So this is suitability of this compaction by rammers. Tampers or rammers can be used to compact soil adjacent to existing structure or confined areas such as trenches and behind the bridge abutment, where other methods of compaction cannot be used. Owing very low output, tampers are not economical where large quantity of soils are involved. They can be used for all types of soils. Third one is compaction by vibratory compactor. In vibratory compactor, vibrations are induced in soil during compaction. The compactors are available in the variety of forms. When vibrator is mounted on a drum, it is called as vibratory roller. These rollers are available both as pneumatic type and smooth wheel type. In the smooth wheel type, a separate motor drives an arrangement of eccentric weights to create high frequency, low amplitude up and down oscillation of the drum. Suitability of this is vibratory compactors can compact the granular soils to a very high maximum dry density. These are suitable for compacting granular soils with no fines in layer up to 1 cm thick. Last one is compacting by tamping. Tamping rod is used to compact coarse grained cohesionless soil of lesser thickness. Degree of compaction, the ratio of compacted density of the field to the standard modified Proctor density for the same soil is called as degree of compaction. So talking about field compaction control, the basic question is whether the required degree of compaction is achieved after compaction or not. It has to be determined for each compacted layer. This is determined with the help of controlled values of OMC and MDA. On each layer at number of locations, in situ density determination is done along with its moisture content determination. If more than 2/3 of all the moisture content values are in the range of plus or minus 2% above OMC, it can be concluded that a proper control over moisture is exercised. Similarly, if 3/4 of all the field density values are higher or near about MDD value, compaction can be termed satisfactory.